The COSASA chairperson, Joel Senyonyi, sanctioned a directive in the presence of deputy directors Grace Akulo, the human resource, Justice Akankwasa, engineering, Moses Waibi, the treasurer, Doreen Akatuhwera, Simon Kasiate for communication, and Frank Rusa, the director of legal services.
So let's have those documents by close of business Monday next week. Okay, and then we'll see you on 6th June.
It should be noted that while appearing before COSASA on May 11, 2023, the Lord Mayor Elias Lukwago disclosed that KCCA in 2021 acquired a $288 million loan from the African Development Bank to construct 200 kilometers of roads in Kampala, but this money only covered 69.7 kilometers. According to the Lord Mayor, this meant that the unit cost of a kilometer was 15.4 billion shillings, which is the highest in the region.
So when we were interacting with them, they brought heavy documents, procurement and all of that. At that time, we had not perused them. Now that we have looked at them, there are things which don't properly add up. We want them to explain to us those procurements. Those roads which you find a road, you know, 1 kilometer is costing 15 billion, 14 billion, 10 billion, 1 kilometer like this.
Bid documents indicate that KCCA in 2021 advertised the signalization of 5 junctions and reconstruction of 18.84 kilometers of roads in Makindye Central, Kawempe and Lubaga divisions, among others. Channelization of 3.9 kilometers of drainages in Lubaga division was also part of this undertaking.
Our procurement documents for these roads, there are some missing documents therein, the internal audit report, and a couple of other documents for us to be able to ascertain what they're telling us.
Legislators have also tasked KCCA to explain with documented evidence on alleged mismanagement of revenue generated from market dues. MPs noted that they received reports that vendors in several markets are not given receipts for dues collected by KCCA market masters.
These markets, Nakawa, where they are paying money, I think they were saying 15,000 per person per day, but they don't get receipts. And it was all over, it was on Radio One. So I would like to know how you collect that money from the markets, how you deposit it, how you reconcile. Did you, the person in charge of revenue collection?
Of how revenue is handled in KCCA. Make a comprehensive write up and also give it to us, and we shall internalize it.
COSASA also wants KCCA to explain in detail as to why they continue to pay officials in acting capacity years after their superiors relinquished offices.
But for assignment of duties allowances, they cannot go beyond 6 months. But there are some staff of KCCA who have been earning that money for even 5 years, 7 years, which is very irregular and illegal.
Specifically, the aforementioned officers include Caleb Mogisha, who handed over office last month after serving as acting director legal affairs since 2019. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.